Okay. So there's a lot of things going on in the world right now. Last week I talked to Americans directly. I know you're having hard times right now, and I wanted to encourage you through those things. Another one is people trying to change history or trying to erase history. I'm not quite sure what they're trying to do. Anyway, I don't want to talk about either of those things. I want to talk about the fight.
There's Nikki and me, and we're celebrating her birthday, Michelle, and we're at a restaurant.
Is this live?
No.
It feels kind of live.
Yeah.
It's not. It's for the vlog. It's going to be called Happy Birthday, Michelle.
Wow.
It's actually not.
You going to cut this?
Cut what?
This whole thing you've been doing.
Cut what?
Or is it going to make the cut?
It might make the cut. Why do you want to say something?
Is this your personal collection or your vlog collection?
Vlog collection.
Wait,
I
want to talk about the fight. The biggest pay-per-view event in history. It's crazy how much money went through this thing. Now, I know as well, people are triggered because why is there so much money being spent on this? Well, I don't know. But I will say this, that the reality is that money on entertainment and the spending of that happens astronomically larger scale, more proportion every single day across the globe. And so why does one event trigger people to say, hey, that's not right? My question is, are those people, maybe you're one of them, have you done anything about it? See, the thing is, we kind of live for entertainment, don't we? I'm not gonna say that you can't go out and have entertainment. In fact, right now I think some people just need to have some fun to get off the kicks that I just talked about at the beginning. If you're one of the ones that called out this fight for being a waste, I'm gonna call BS. What have you done today to stop yourself from wasting resources? Did you cut off your daily coffee at the store? Did you not go out for lunch or dinner? And did you take that money that you would have spent at that place and give it to the people that you were crying out for in the first place? You see, it's really funny. It's easy to throw rocks when everybody else is with you. You heard the phrase as well, don't throw rocks if you live in a glass house. And I would wager to say that most people that live in North America and Western Europe, we have a lot. So what are we doing daily to help those people you were freaking out for just a few days ago? It is the night of the fight, the great fight. My prediction is this person wins. Well, not you, Jer, but yeah. So we're at Roger's place, going in a very cool room. We'll show you in a minute. Here, where I'm gonna watch the fight, it is the private room. I'll show you. Grand Villa Casino in Edmonton, Alberta. Pretty awesome. To me, why not watch the fight here? Let's go. The fight is starting. Oh my God. It's all over. The fight's over.
Everybody is a winner.
Well, except for Mcgregor. He lost.
Technically.
We had a great time at the fights. This Jared doing, or John doing his own filming. There's Mcgregor there. And his date, I'm assuming. Well, did you guys have fun?
Oh, yeah.
There it is.
Yeah.
Yeah, you had fun, John?
Yeah.
All right.
Put that down, John. Love it when you hit the ground, John.
Part two is this, is that we always have the best outlook on ourselves. We always have the best view of ourselves. We always look at ourselves and cast the least amount of judgment upon our own lives, our own situations, our own actions. And you've seen that throughout history. People committing heinous crimes, downplaying them. But if that principle's true for that level, how much more is it true for the things that don't seemingly seem criminal? You see, when we throw judgment on something and we blame others for something else, we must understand. You know, I'm not against calling out what's right and wrong. I'm not against that. However, when you cast judgment on someone else, you have to be ready for something. Every time you point your finger, there's more pointing back at you. And so when you're sitting there on your comfy couch, looking at your great computer or your cell phone, hurling insults at people, can you look in the mirror? A great test to see if you're actually doing the things you're upset about is, even with your limited resources, let's say you have $10, how much of that can you give away before it hurts? Or will you try to hold on to what you have left? It's one thing to call out extravagant, unnecessary things. I agree. It's a lot of money that was spent on this fight. A lot of that resource could have gone to help something else, but at the end of the day, it's not really just about that one event. It's about the heart of people, once again. I'm all about this, and I won't give up talking about looking in the mirror for each individual on the face of the planet. Why? Because you can remove all of the events that were too much, and the problem would still remain. People are selfish, people are greedy, people don't want to go without. To me, it's never just about the one event. It might shed light on something, but the light that shines has to hit somewhere, and it isn't the event. It's right here. Unless we can let that light shine and hit right here, we have nothing. Nothing will change. Things will go on as they are. If you're one of the ones that wants change, that wants to see something shift, let the light hit you and examine yourself to see if you as well are a part of the problem. Then you can complain about the event. See you next time. Don't you